Hey guys, this probably not the best video. I know you can't see me. I got the camera set up and everything so you can see the lathe. This one's kind of more for me than you. I know that sounds odd, but part of my accident, I suffer really badly from chronic pain. I had extensive nerve damage. That's part of the reason my arm doesn't work. Really, really bad nerve damage, and I have chronic nerve pain. And it gets so bad that I can't even sit still. It hurts, and I mean, you want to scream. Like, it's like fibromyalgia on steroids. So what I do is I try to take my mind off it, and that's kind of how I got into wood turning to begin with. So this is nothing fancy. I just threw a chunk of wood on there, and I just trying to get my mind off it. So here we go. Chunk of mulberry. I'm not 100% positive, but pretty sure. I've mentioned it before, I do my tenons a little differently than a lot of people do. I actually put the tenon on before I shape the outside of the bowl. And that's mainly because I'm left-handed. And it's hard for me to stand back here, support with my hip, and try to get the good shape on the bowl. It's easier for me to go to the top down. So I usually roughly get it round, put the tenon on, and flip it around. I know it's backwards from a lot of people, but it's just the way I do it. It's easier for me. Thank you. low, so I'll just go a little more. Gonna be loud. That's how I make my tenon. I know I've said I've done it different before, but when I use a bowl gouge, I don't know if you can see it. It's got a nice taper. I use a bowl gouge, go and twist it at the end so it doesn't catch on the wings, and my wings are really swept back, and it's perfect shape for the tenon. This, so I'm not 100% sure what I'm even trying to do here, but that'll work for the outside. Thank you. roughly how deep I want for rough out. I'm gonna go a little thick because I don't know if I'm gonna keep that foot on it or not. Probably will. Definitely a ways to go. Seeing inside.